38-hour total shutdown of JCRLTS paralyzes life in the valley. Protesters block main roads in Imphal city. 5 persons, including 3 women, injured as police fire tear gas shells to disperse JCRLTS protesters at Kaisampa. JCRLTS supporters halt media team on duty on the road. Amju appeals for cooperation. A team of journalists led by Amju visits 2 central jails, finds maximum number of under trials lodged in Imphal and Sajiva central jail. Hello and welcome to Impact News. You're watching Evening News. I'm Tenshumam Sangeeta with top stories and latest news at this hour. The 38-hour total shutdown imposed by Joint Committee on Inner Line Permit System completely paralyzed life in the valley today. JCRLTS yesterday announced a 38-hour shutdown from 4 a.m. today till 6 p.m. tomorrow. JCRLTS had accused the government of indulging in delaying tactics over making the 3 bills passed by State Assembly into an act. The Joint Committee had appealed to the people to cease work and join the agitation. During the total shutdown today, government offices recorded low attendance. Government and private educational institutions, all commercial activities including commercial establishments, remained closed. Protesters blocked roads and shouted slogans in support of inner line permit system. Roads in Imphal East wore deserted look with educational institutions and commercial establishments being closed. Low attendance was also recorded at the DC Complex SDO office. Locals block roads at various localities in Imphal East in support of ILPS by placing woodlocks, stones and bamboos. The road stretch from Kongwa to Porompat and Kurai Ayangpali was also blocked. Similar scenes were also seen at Kurai Lamlong area. Local residents also block Larihem Bamlekai. The cease work was relaxed for religious functions, emergency cases, students appearing in BA and BSc 6th semester examinations and media persons. There were, however, reports of patient parties facing problems as Bund supporters allegedly forced them to divert their routes. Cease work severely affected life in Imphal West on the first day today. Major roads in Imphal West district such as Tidem Road, Uripo Kangchub Road, Imphal Jiribam Road, Mayai Lambi and Imphal Moray Road were deserted look as protesters took to streets to enforce the total shutdown. Protesters blocked the roads and prevented traffic movement except medical services, religious and other essential services. Business establishments in Khwairamban Market, Pauna Bazaar and Thangal Bazaar down their shutters for the day today. The 38-hour cease work severely affected life in Bishnupur district as well. Markets in the district were closed. People also blocked all roads in the district and restricted vehicular movement. Sources say the cease work was also effective in different parts of Thobal district as well. Movement of traffic on Imphal Jiribam Highway was also badly hit by the cease work. Protesters blocked roads demanding conversion of the 3 bills passed by the State Assembly into an act. They blocked the road at Sagolban, Tera Lukram Lairak Machin, Moirang Hanuba and Takiel Kolom Lekai in support of the demand of JCRLTS. The cease work also affected Imphal Sangai Thel Road. People blocked the road at Langjing, Tharoijam Lamkhai, Salama Mangla Lekai, Patsoi Path 3. Residents of Sagolmang and Khewa Merapaibi representatives blocked the Imphal Cycle Road and Sagolmang Sombung Road in Kundrapum Assembly Constituency in Imphal East in support of the JCRLTS tour. Five persons, including 3 women, were injured when police tried to disperse a group of ILP protesters who were taking out a rally from Tidem Road towards the Chief Minister's bungalow this afternoon. The protesters were coming from Kwakaithil shouting slogans when they were stopped at Kaisampa traffic point by the police personnel who were already stationed there. Scuffles ensued between the police and the protesters as the latter struggled to proceed further. Police fired tear gas shells and stun grenades to disperse the protesters. Police personnel continued to keep a strict vigil in the area to prevent any untoward incident. JCRP students wing strongly condemned the police action against protesters who took part in a democratic rally on Thithim Road this afternoon, where five persons were injured. Speaking at a press meet held at the office of JCRPS at Konjeng Hazari Lekai, convener of the students' wing, Nanda Babu Oinam, said, "Time has now come to teach the government a lesson and appeal to the people to intensify the agitation." He said people are also requested to shout slogan, "No ILP, no government," during the protest tomorrow. Nanda Babu, however, appealed to the volunteers not to give trouble to patients, media persons, people going for religious functions, and students appearing in the Indian Council of Agriculture Research Examination schedule for tomorrow.
Nasigi tabi draba government si ta na makhali khongjang adu chakshin bina ba yasi RPS sin ma makai digi abil jaji lo na mayam lauri khola si tabi bangi mohta khaksen andana osen andana thoko je ma khoi ma ta lewa mayam na chap chapa para tambi ma thamadu yorora hari khaji matam khri manung da choina mukta ba leba khoi yelo mising achi mutri ma ma da atu mitu mian jasi na puna yo tri ma da khoi ma cha ma na puna momin na ji ra hai ba khoma si sin sin makai mi makai digi ma di yasi RPS makai digi ngasi gi lenga achi da hajari.
ILP supporters today caught two men with psychotropic substance WY tablets at Kongwa Kunau. The incident occurred in the evening today. ILP supporters stopped a maroon Alto car with registration number MN01K8205, which was registered in the name of alleged vice president of AMUCO. The car was driving from Irilbung to Kongwa area when the volunteers of Sedok Club, Kongwa Kunau, and Imoinu Women Welfare Association caught the two men with the WY tablets. The vehicle was damaged by the locals. The two men have been identified as Nomaithim Dhanabir Singh, age 30, son of N. Chauba from Urup Litan Makhung, and Mohammed Sajibur, age 36, son of Islauddin from Urup Wangma. The damaged vehicle and the two men were later handed over to Irilbung police by the volunteers.
Nupa anisi koi ki gari tonga ga hai galak panne ba makhar asom dagi aduga anisi koi ki nupam sa jing koi jing jina koi changja laga jiang ba matam da ma koi guli phare ma koi na lak ba matam da koi ki amuko gi mami season dare ga amuko gi official sare ga amuko gi diver ni na haizen da na khosan da na tau dagi ma koi bu nisaban mai na pai bi jing jina adugo ba do kanu matung da ma gi gyan ta na ba koi khara hai re ga matung da amu ana tau da na ba ma koi khara Barakwatem Meraga, Hui Marani Matungina, Hui Police, the Sinazakre.
JCILP Student Wing has claimed that the BA and BSc examinations conducted by Manipur University during the 38-hour ceasework of the JCILPS to protect the indigenous people cannot be considered valid and must be rescheduled. Convener of the Students Wing, Oinam Nanda Babu, today told media persons at JCILPS office that the representatives of JCILPS Student Wing yesterday met the Controller of Examination and Registrar of Manipur University, requesting them to postpone the examination in view of the ceasework. He lamented the decision of the university authorities to continue with the semester examination today. He maintained that many students could not appear in today's examination due to the ceasework and should be rescheduled.
Kau exam control dah, kau unam mangsun unam cacei hari bah exam masih hari bah semua kudung tiba tahu dosis teruk buaya macam na, wasmu tahu ina bah, orang kudung tak menghajar bni, kau menghajar bersih wang muda, kau gigi bisi na, yang terus hajar masih exam masih nampu dek toksing kere, adu hari bah exam masih nampu dek toksing mana mana, wajib na, tahu lepas tahu masih punu punu masih, kau gigi, mana bini masih gigi bisi yang dia otoriti nampu kudung menghajar jesse, api sini cuma macam thamjadi loi na, masih pantau kibah exam masih sana biar roy, masih punu gigi dah jesse, yang dia otoriti masih bisi nampu kudung ni.
Volunteers of the 38-hour cease work imposed by a joint committee on inner line permit system today halted a team of journalists led by President of All Manipur Working Journalists Union, Wanghim Chas Chamjai, at Khurai Sajor Lekai. The incident occurred while the media persons were proceeding towards Sajiva Central Jail to cover an event this morning. AMJU President Chamjai has appealed to the JCILPS to prevent such incident in future.
Media and my using Nunshad Akugi Mam Punamaki, Seruksan, the dear Ting Matin, the High Hibani, which is a gay, High Matam, the Akubu, Minit Taram, Akugi Mona, Tingina. I can't know why he had a press, which no one of the Sapiru headed to Yowi. So when I walk in Tanada, Matopus, he couldn't wait. Sankili, he was him, Mumiam with the Mokini, Miam Punamaki, Gantaminasi, Anayaki, Hekjobulak, but put a key to a guy, Miami, a see Nana Traga, Pau Yori. So much Pajana Hangi Raganda, Kraila Punaka, Chapika, Hagi, Madame Savalegate, Hadopu, Adana, Akura Hana, and Akura Pilto Zubasi, Sitabi Draganda, Punisogotba, Kambushing Sena. Press the hyper identity card, not the Yanzaraba, press hyper jacket, Pajana Utpiraba, a quite identity tab of Hawa Dawina, a quibu, Pajana, the Sapiru headed to set of Bigino Hajana, Mayam Punamok, Amokan Hajak, Hiram Shimatanga, Jesse Alpes Kamunasu, Hanahana Mayam, the Apil Togian, Tabinova, Sindhu.
Indian Red Cross Society Manipur State Branch Honorary Secretary Dr. Y. Mohan has appealed to the supporters of the JCILPS not to obstruct the Red Cross team. He said, JCILPS supporters along Tudem Road blocked a team of Red Cross on their way to pick up an injured ILP protester. He further appealed to the public to help the Red Cross team instead of preventing them to do their duty.
Red Cross ambulance ne tharibu gari se koi ban sogot piriba ban implementori ba isi naukhara na khamaga ana ba yaubra kada busti lino kran chiru ne hangbo khot pasi mapam mani hum da thengna jai. Masi di to hon janing di tiar gi asta rubber bullet na khot pa pan ba khole he ba yau bde gi khoi praja gi cheba to jege na pick up to jege na sa sa bani rubber bullet na kapla sok pa masu pukhal laga hop sand athil jeram mi madui matung da tai further sok pa yau cha pani media gi thong appeal to janing hi bdi ambulance na tra red cross staff sing sat kan da ban gu matam or ilp khang de mai ban khang de staff sing da apan ba pe bi gnu.
Members of Manipur University Students Union today vandalized four boys' hostels on the university campus and set fire to furniture of the hostel, protesting the authorities' failure to provide proper infrastructure in the four hostels. The protesting students also vowed to launch intense agitation if the demands are not met immediately. MUSU General Secretary Oinam Prem Sagar stated that four hostels where around 400 students are living do not have proper electricity and water supply. He said enough number of beds is not even provided to the hostelers and toilets and bathrooms are in deplorable condition. Grasses and bushes cover the surroundings of the hostel and portions of hostels damaged by the recent earthquake are not repaired yet. Prem Sagar added that the university authority has been apprised of the grievous inconveniences many times.
Manipur University ki authority na asoiba award pa lairiba mayam singh asi musuna barveli amadi written oina hai khiba mayam thabak to unthorok taba koi ge hojik lairiba sanitation adagi fooding lodging adagi infrastructure gi oiba magi building structure oiba sida asoiba na karigumba khudong cha daba madagi hekta namtha duna tukhi ge da koi mong de lairiba mong singh asi ubada yamna ngai jade hostel lairiba singh asi yamna hostel accommodation asi complete oina amadi yamna afawa yamna central university ge amgi amma oibagi yamna phajaba hostel sing adu ohen bi authority na tumina tadana lairagadi asidagi henba khongjang kyamasu sangse lakhi ba ya.
Let's take a small commercial break. We'll be back in a short while. Keep watching Impact News.
Delta Tutorials for CBSE. Admissions open. Class 9, 10 and 12 Science from April 4. Class 12 Arts from May 4. Class 11 Science from June 6. Vacation course for Navodayas and others from May 4. Class timing 5:30 to 9:30 a.m. and 4:30 to 7:30 p.m. For details, please visit Delta Tutorials between 6 a.m. to 7 p.m.
The first urban cross hatchback Datsun Ready Go with 800cc, Supna Tagilupalak Animakai Piva car Sigi feature Singhi, ground clearance 185mm, space 222 liters, power steering, drive computer, mileage 25.14 km per liter, immobilizer, passing class warranty. Lupali sing mga khatana book to bihauro, Island Nissan near Standard Robert Higher Secondary School, Kanchipur, Imphal. Datsun Ready Go.
Manipur ge ahamba beautification center mapham sida mahing uring unsa khoiba ari badakfam phahan bangami tetu mall freckle naching basu lothok payai hakchang ge ahem ba fat palm da body ge hair lothok payai ahamba lakpi ba 100 customer da skin test amadi doctor consultation lemne engzagan ngasima unaview doctor Madhubala laser beauty clinic mz avenue Imphal.
Welcome back. You're watching Primetime English News. Media persons led by President of All Manipur Working Journalists Union, Wanghimcha Syamjai, under the aegis of Directorate of Information and Public Relations, during a visit to two central jails of the state today, learned that the number of under trials lodged in the two jails of the state is more than the convicts. Out of the 578 inmates in central jail Sajiva, 466 are under trials and 42 are convicts. And out of 50 inmates in central jail Imphal, 9 are under trials and 1 is a convict. The team met both the superintendents of Central Jail Sajiva and Central Jail Imphal and the inmates during the visit. Superintendent of Central Jail Imphal, T.S. Subhachandra, said excess number of under trials is giving a hard time to the jail authority and the inmates.
Jail si dah ikhwan lahir, kau si dah semua ikhwan dah tengah jari si conviction gi pirak pagi sanksi, tu ke mending niem kira Manipur si. Aidi atau apa state tadi lahir bersi prisoner whole prisoner population si dekik 1/3 gum mending convict lahir aga, 1% gum mending aku UTP ina lahir bina. Maram si nama iki atau apa jail, bapaan gi jail si tadi, aku gi any development works aku gi industry gum ba. Aduh, ini kanos ki vocation training ki am successfully tau bungam eh. Aduh, Manipur ni masih tau bungam dia. Ngam tapi maram si, oji ki conviction ki peras si leh tau maram jin.
Many under trials prisoners expressed their discontentment over the delay in the trial by the low court and prolonged stay in the jail. Inmates also drew the attention of the authority concerned to expedite their trial, and they are ready to accept any punishment if they are convicted. They keep them as under trials for a long period.
When a top of a tongue case, I'm going to give up. I did political regional moments, can not open enough. Some ponina, I got the government and PV with the Zara to be Biro, I do Isanian, Jerry, my name's Elton, Tambiran, come down, while just in the go to the day, I said, Toya and Yumila to Ohio. I do you need? I got my two things. I'm getting it. I don't know, Paris, man, beginning with Zara to government, beginning with Zara to in a government land, horror, you know. I do in Shania, there is Biro in the United States.
One-day interaction on border equitable community development was organized by Department of Commerce and Industries at Moray Trade Center Hall yesterday. Improvement of trade relations with India-Myanmar and development of infrastructure including roads and bridges were discussed at the event. The issue over harassment of traders by custom officers at gate number 2, Namphalong, was also discussed. Commerce and Industries Minister Konthojam Govindas, who was the chief guest of the event, said Moray is an important trade center for Manipur and India. He appealed to all communities living in the border to live together in peace and harmony. He urged them to strive for development and progress. The minister assured that once the integrated checkpost is completed, all the problems will be solved. Maitri Council Moray, Tamil Sangam Moray, Manipuri Muslim Council Moray, All Community Development Organization Moray, Border Trade Chamber of Commerce Moray and representatives of NGOs attended the event. Family of Moirang Mayum Chawwa, age 60, of Samuro Awanglekai accepted his body after post-mortem examination. Chawwa, who left his house on 12th of May, was found dead on 15th of May near the Nambul River between Samuro and Thaunaujam Khul. Wangoi police arrested Namayrapam Sukhdev, age 23, son of Gopi Mohan of Samuro Mamanglekai, in connection with the murder. Locals today held a sit-in against the assault of Khadibam Hutter, also known as Tombo of Thongju Part 2, Namayrapam Lekai by Thongju MLA Thongam Bishwajit on the 18th of this month during distribution of ration cards under National Food Security Act at Koman Zone 3. They questioned why a representative of the people assaulted Tomba and expressed dissatisfaction over the silence of the MLA on the incident. The protesters said if the MLA does not clarify the matter, they will launch intense agitation.
kaya marala lagi pergi juha mahai biru rawa. Aku cai cikit dia, aku mami cuci. Masa cai rung bauling bayar de, ada gini manakung nama horo horo lawa lagi aku gini nakungji kereta. Asyik aku macam tunggu kali gede cila kata gini kang dapat matam jeda. Asyik tak way wana lagi kan jeda. Aku gini ipi ipa hori baru cingba. Mahak na, aku gini penjat riba mipai riba saya. Sibu kali lagi bagi hai bapa magi makai lagi amat tak kau nak pang dapat saya. Masih aku yang menunggai jadi mahak ini makai lagi aku ningba aku nak apa mbak pen bapa kau pang di bawah aku lep tanah kongjeng kali tahu juga hai bapa kongjeng beri culek lep ceroy.
R.K. Joysana, an independent candidate of Ward No. 20 under Yai School Assembly constituency, withdrew his nomination. With his withdrawal, the Congress and BJP candidate will have a street fight in the ward now. Mention may be made that the first member of Ward No. 18 under the same constituency yesterday withdrew his nomination paper.
Ayang nama saya Tizaru Mamatamda, Aiki Watsida, Tahi Mari Mangagi Mamang Dagi Mukoisi Laitren Tabadagi, Aina Masi State Election Commission Da, Masi Proxy Board, Oihan Biganu, Haidan Ayang Natazabani, Aduna Revision Se Lakmanang Dabagi Damakta, Masi Kapadi Nang Zahudre, Election Sinamai Pagadi, Revision Lakmanatamda Mukoisi Soidan Maki, Aiki Watsida Laitrabanina. So then Maki Kaksaragani, Makoina Kariguma, election Sidal Laga, voting right to Piga Haragadi, Madua Aina voting right, Aina Tingbangam de Aina Tazari City, Maduna La Eva Arosing, retaining officer Duna, Makoibu Puxi Sangan Bin, Danabogi the Maktasu, Ayama Madui Pandam, Aina Tazavani.
An independent candidate in the upcoming IMC election and former councillor of Ward No. 11, Firoja Mem Chatombi, today appealed to the authority concerned not to allow seven people who have shifted their homes since the last 3 to 4 years to other places from casting their vote. Speaking to media, Mem Chatombi said, State Electoral Commission was earlier requested to remove their names from the voter list in March, but their names remain in the list as electoral roll revision was not done before the election. Two-day teachers orientation program organized by Cookie Students Organization was held at Hill Tribal Council Conference Hall in Moray this morning. SB Liang Go Ching Hau Kip and Dr. Tin Kong Neng spoke on teaching methodology. 157 teachers of 13 schools in Moray Town attended the orientation program. Speaking to media persons, headmaster of Eastern Shrine School, Samo Singh, said, teachers orientation program is very rare held in Moray and it was a great opportunity for the teachers in Moray.
Teachers orientation program to go sida resource person ni yauraga ko music dariba school sing ja sing ta tu ki ta na bati le maram ti mo sing profession da lai na ko more da smai teachers orientation program to ya ma ta na to 2011 ata ja mo ko to ki bedaki hen na ko le ke re ko song to ko siam ka ga di ko ko siam ka na ba angani hai na ina sai ki khanjari.
The prize distribution ceremony for Sukh's first Ariba Manipuri Dolgi Wahan Thok Changdam No. 2016 and 5th Sukh State Level Spelling Competition 2016 scheduled for tomorrow has been postponed to May 29 due to the JCILPS shutdown. Students Union of Kanglipa Publicity Secretary in a press release informs that the event will be held at 11 a.m. at Adim Jati Shiksha Ashram Chungmairong Khongnang Ani Karak. Ayush Gram under National Ayush Mission was held for Bishnupur District by State Ayush Society Manipur and Universal Vision ISOG at ISOG Bazaar yesterday. The event was attended by representatives of Ayush, NAM and residents of the area. And in sports, NYC defeated LHYC in 3 straight sets. JMT Tadbuk defeated NAYC 3-2 sets, PYC defeated LHYC 3-1 sets, while RYC defeated NAYC in 3 straight sets in the 6th Y. Keshwa Singh Memorial Senior Volleyball Tournament 2016. The tournament is organized by All Jiribam Sports Association at Jiribam Government High Secondary School with 10 teams participating. The tournament is sponsored by former DGP Y. Joy Kumar Singh in memory of his late father. The 23rd State Cadet Senior Waco Kickboxing Championship kicked off yesterday at Sector Community Hall in Imphal East. The tournament is organized by Nawang Sports Academy Sector. At least 150 boys and girls kickboxers representing 12 units are taking part in the championship. Deputy Speaker M.K. Prashosh Shimre, Assistant Professor of Manipur University, M. Chaurajit and sports lovers of the state attended the opening day.
2020 da kari gumba indiana perspective tawba ngamba tarabdi chahi shang na sanrab kanda national da kickboxing championship da manipur na shum champion weragla adni madu na takpati kari gumba indiana kickboxing che olympic da represent tawba taradi manipur ki players sing na martial arts sing na represent tawguni madukidumakta ikon shem saraga thambada abuni.
With that, it's a wrap in this edition of Primetime English News. Before we end, a look at the headlines once again. 38-hour total shutdown of JCRPS paralyzes life in the valley. Protesters block main roads in Imphal city. 5 persons, including 3 women, injured as police fire tear gas shells to disperse JCRPS protesters at Kaisampa. JCRPS supporters halt media team on duty on the road. Amju appeals for cooperation. A team of journalists led by Amju visits 2 central jails, finds maximum number of under trials lodged in Imphal and Sajiva Central Jail.